Welcome back, everybody. Welcome back to the canyon. Welcome back to another Quickview installment. What do we love almost as much as we love disassembling and reassembling beadlocks? New tires. You know what? On further introspection, we might like new tires even more. You know what we're going to do? We're going to cut to the chase. Today's test guy, look at this, Duratrax Approach CR. The sole Duratrax Class 2 that has not been tested here in the canyon. We started with the showdowns. As you can see, they have seen some stuff. They're pretty well worn out. We have plenty of deep woods in the fleet. We haven't found the rig that really sings on scalers. The scalers are the tire in the Duratrax lineup that, to me, I go, they're pretty good, but we always seem to find something better. So I have heard in the past, I've heard the approach described as a less aggressive deep woods, and we're going to see how that goes. In the disclosure for this one, these were provided to me by channel subscriber, and I believe UK resident Lee Jordan, channel subscriber, member, follower, Lee Jordan. He really wanted me to test the Approach CR, so he sent these out to me to be tested. And this is why I cannot speak to mountability. If I didn't mention that, this is why I can't speak to mountability, because the only way to get them was pre-mounts glued onto these. And you notice how clean the rims are using the tried and true welding gloves, heat gun, and Bob Smith Industries Uncure. Rims came off clean. These guys were definitely paid by the hour. I have never in my life seen as much glue on a tire as what was on these. It took over an hour to get these removed from the wheels, and it was not fun, and it was not easy. So if these do indeed test well, and I think they're going to do at least fine, if they do well, whatever you do, if you're planning on mounting them on a beadlock, don't buy the pre-mounts, because I used to think that getting these off the wheels was difficult. These, removing a canyon trail is a dream compared to removing Duratrax pre-mounts. They are on their included foams, Duratrax mediums, vented at the usual 6 o'clock, 12 o'clock positions. They went on fairly easily, despite the fact that, I mean, you can see the beads are still crusted with super glue. The super glue was a genuine problem. They feel, honestly, like every other Duratrax tire that I've used. They use that C3 compound on everything. They always come with a little sticker that has all these, like C1, C2, 3. To my knowledge, I mean, maybe in other stuff, like buggy tires and stuff, they use different compounds, but they've C3. So far as I know, all of the crawler tires are C3. Now, we're using mental force to remember the six points of testing. And unfortunately for the approaches, fortunately or unfortunately, we'll see how they do. Baseline, the test rig, was recently set up with these, which are the inexplicably heavy Hot Storm beadlocks. The beadlock itself weighs 149 grams. He's running double buns, which is closed cell inner, hair bun outer. These are cut and siped canyon trails, and this is the set of canyon trails that was treated with Monster Grip rubber treatment. They are also worn to about that perfect amount of feathering on the edge. So this wheel tire combo has a near extreme amount of traction. Like, they have traction on par, honestly, with anything else in the fleet. So that is the memory that is freshest in my mind, having driven on these, which just, when I hold them in my hand, the set, I should, in the spirit of fair play, these are just mounted on a typical Enjora Method 105 clone. I am genuinely curious. One of these combos comes in at 255 grams for those here in America. That is 9 ounces dead? 8.95 ounces. By contrast, the Approach mounted here are 5.75 ounces apiece, 163 grams. 90 grams per corner might be something of an issue. I mean, that means that the full set is 1,010 grams. It's a kilo. So we've got a kilo for the set. We've got 655 grams, which is pretty light. Lighter than where I generally like to be. And while we're at it, I guess we can tell you what this guy wheelless comes in at. 2,100 grams. He is 4.7 pounds. So he definitely constitutes as a lightweight, seeing as his wheel tire combo is a third of the weight of the vehicle. So that is a ratio of unsprung to sprung that even I ordinarily don't manage to attain. Once again, baseline proving that it does not matter what wheel or tire you put on him, he's going to make it look good. I'm not going to say I have outstandingly high hopes for the Duratrax Approach, but I've yet to meet a Duratrax tire that I didn't like. Like I say, the scaler just hasn't found its home. We haven't found the rig that sings on that tire, but they're not a bad tire. They got replaced by some Vanquish Falcon Wild Peaks. And honestly, the grip profile on the Falcons is about the same. It's just a matter of the fact that I think the Falcons look a lot better. So they lost out on cosmetics because, you know, they call this a scaler, which, I mean, on what planet? Like, terrible grip aside, like that's a scale tire. That's a scale tire. So it's the least scale tire, I think, certainly, that has scale in its name. And it's just never been wow. So it gets sidelined due to that. It's been long enough now that I can't even remember how the review on the scaler went. But I assume it's a solid 5 out of 7. It's okay. It's pretty good. And the Duratrax strength, where Duratrax, I think where their advantage really lies is that typically a pair of tires is in that like sub $25, $21, $22 a pair. And their performance on their stock foams is generally quite good. Right on par with J Concepts, but a slightly cheaper tire. So that's enough of that. I think I have discussed it enough. Baseline is going to come out with us. We are going to try to hit the 6, if I can remember what the 6 are. I know there was Sidehill involved, and we will see how the Approach do. And honestly, I'm fingers crossed all around that it's not just self-fulfilling prophecy that I have a preconceived notion and I'm not just trying to zing it out. I want them to be good on their own merits, but in my head, obviously, I'm going to be comparing them to these, and I'm also going to be comparing to how the Deep Woods have done in the past. So we will see. I have the Sidehill fresh in my head. I've got Slick Rock fresh in my head. We will see. I hope for good things, but I try not to get my hopes too high because, you know, I am perpetually disappointed. I just took about 10 minutes to quick seek through my own most recent tire test video because I couldn't remember what the 6 things I did was. That's a pass. That's a strong pass. Yeah, that smaller lug actually You see a little drift there, but actually it feels so. I would put this right in between the Scaler and the Deepwoods in terms of lug size, and I think that particular climb there was most suited to this lug size. All the Duratrax tires, as I've mentioned in other Duratrax videos, but I don't assume people have this degree of continuity in their heads. All the Duratrax Class 2 tires are the same size. Not bad, a little pushy there where we're into the fence, but could have just been entry angle as well. Drag brake test, get it right here. That's real good. You see that driver front hanging up on that kidney bean rock. If you can hang up, Kevin! If you can hang up on that, you're doing okay. So you're going back up. Yeah, that's real good. That's really quite promising for the approach out of the gate. Not bad at all. Of course, into Daphne's of the line. The breach here should be the same as it has been in recent days, as it's the same tire height as all the others. It's this grab right here. Can we grab that? Oh, that's really good. Watching that rear. Oh, that's really good. Have I? I think I've slept on the approach off of the, again, here we are, preconceived notion that it is a less aggressive deep woods. But it would certainly appear that in this early on in the testing, yes, I don't need that big lug of the deep woods. Look at, yeah, that's excellent. That was truly excellent. Both of those hits there, very good. Duratrax approach, you're looking really, really good. Gotta get a little messy here. I just broomed out the little inland sea. I don't want to get too much water into a brand new set of open cell foams. Again, we're shooting for that crack, trying to get a little bit to the right hand side of it. Okay. Bellied up a little, so we're gonna try it. We'll try a left pivot. See how the rear. Yeah, that's genuinely that's quite a lot of grip. I am most pleasantly surprised here. A little puddly action there. Roll into Quailin. Sacrifice. Just trying to get it nice and high up there. I want to see how much mush. No, a good little, like a squidge from that low rear, but like really manageable. When I was mounting these, I told myself half a dozen times to take a picture of it. The foam looks bigger than the medium that's typically in a Duratrax. And I was like, what? Like, compared to the size of the tire, the foam is probably 12 to 15 millimeters taller when it's outside of the tire. Like, it's huge. You're really mashing that foam in there. And maybe this is something newer? Like, has Duratrax gone to a larger foam? The compound feels exactly the same. It feels like every other Duratrax medium. But like in here, in this side hill action, he's pretty flexed up, cross-flexed here. I don't feel any looseness to it at all. I'm looking at that front under there. The amount of mush looks good. It's got like just a right amount of slip. Now mind you, 4.7 pounds rig. So 4.7 pounds rig without wheels and tires. I'm trying to definitely get into the habit of doing weights on rigs without wheels and tires, because wheels and tires are purely unsprung So this is how we work our ratio of sprung to unsprung. Axles, unless they have a ton of brass on them or alloy or etc., they are not very heavy. So your wheel tire combo is almost certain to be heavier than your axles. So this guy is driving, honestly, like I showed, 90 grams a corner came off going from those hot storms with the Dead Ringer Canyon trails to these. These feel, look at him just sliding. These feel 85% as grippy. And these are fresh out of the package. Unless your compound is super, super sticky, fresh out of the package isn't going to be the highest grip you're going to get. You need that. You need those lugs to start to break in a little, feather in a little. And then, you know, grip will gradually fall away. But for how light these combos are relative to what I ordinarily mount, these are doing really well. We're going to get even more off camber here as that front end tries to climb up. And it's going to get really, really light in the rear end. And generally right about here, we would roll out. But we're trying to take it real slow. I'm trying to get that passenger front to hook over the top like that. Oop. Didn't quite have it. But real, honestly, and as I do trend to hyperbole, remarkably good. On to what I've just been calling the pull-up right there. Not as good of a shadow as there was on it during the last tire test, but it goes past vertical. It's kind of bubbled out. And I have to note to myself, you can see the water line there where the bucket is at the beast. And that's full of water, so I will make an effort to try to stay out of that. We're going to hit this guy, the pull-up, and we're going to hit the L. We'll see how this does. My most recent memory of going over this was on the Baja Claws. Had to use a little, no, MT-104, 1904s. Yeah. So right here, you're hoping for the front. And then that rear, see, you get the slide back because it goes past vertical. And the front end doesn't really have a lot to grab onto, so you're kind of seeking for grip. And basically what you have to do is shuttle back and forth like this. And I find the easiest way is to pull around here to the right. And then once we can get some bite on that front, we can pull the rear up just like that. So there has not been a tire yet that has successfully just pulled straight up that thing. I think especially there's no baseline, has no added weight. That 1200 has got a lot of drag brake. So we'll see here. Ordinarily, tires when tested, there's going to be a lot of slip and spin right in here in the middle. And sometimes it comes down to, are we going to have to bump onto the L or can we just pull onto the L? See, here's the slippy section. Drop it down a little. Not a lot of side bite on this tire. Not a lot of side bite. This is a section that is kind of relying on side bite because right there, when I'd be at full lock, I'm trying to grab that little angle there, right here. Just trying to give me something to pull up. All right, so we're gonna try it. We're gonna try a bump up. It was actually too much. When I bumped it and then it caught, it was a goer. Now, even without the side bite that we would get from, like, say something like a G-Made 1904, self-righting went really well. Yeah, if I were gonna detract a point, if I were gonna be the judge that throws in that low ball score, I would say it's a little bit unpredictable when you get here. It's got the grip, but it's a little bit unpredictable. Like it gets a little shooty, but pulls over real nice here. Get a little bite on the rear. Yeah, excellent. throttle down. Yeah, really very good. Yeah, I keep remarking in these videos how I'm consistently surprised at the performance of OE foams, the foam that is included with the tire, because there are a lot of manufacturers out there, let's not name names, let's focus on the Duratrax approach, but there are a lot of manufacturers out there that will include the OE foam, and that foam is it's just a discardable, like it's not usable in that tire. And Duratrax and J Concepts really kind of lead the way in the opposite spectrum of that. You can get pretty far on that medium if your rig falls into that, you know, happy medium. If you're not excessively heavy or excessively light, this foam is going to perform for you. And I don't consider 4.7 pounds no wheel tire to be excessively light. That's probably in a sort of a sweet spot middle ground. Yeah, there's a lot of forward drive in these. If there's a point deduction, it's because it actually, the approach has less side lug than the scaler, which I think maybe somebody reversed the names. I think this tire should be called the scaler CR and the other one should be called the approach CR. Drop. Because it just doesn't have the side bite. But what it does have is a lot of forward drive. So when you can get the tire over onto the obstacle, when you get the contact patch into the right place, maybe you're climbing. Yeah, it's really predictable. The positioning is really good. I was really surprised by the side hilling. And then seeing as we've kind of breezed through this pretty quickly, we're going to go past the 6, and I'm just going to get some more thoughts collected. I did some walking math on the way, and I am cognizant that, like, okay, Slick Rock, the dog leg at Drybone Valley, that's two things in one location, so it's one setup. And then we have Daphne's Other Line and that little section adjacent to Daphne's Other Line, which I really haven't named yet. So that's two in one setup. And then we go to the backside of Undertaker with that climb up the really sticky mortar mix section with the crack section. And then we do the side hill, Quailin, the side hill. That's two setups in one thing. So that's technically six already. And then we move to the Beast and we do the pull up and we do the L. So that's actually eight things that we've tested. So maybe we'll just add two things here at Oblivion, and then it will be 10 things, five setups of two things each. Like I say, my memory was never very good, and it has gotten worse. So I would apologize for repeating myself when I repeat myself, but I'm going to repeat myself all the time because I can't remember if I said it. Also, and I think I have mentioned this, something about internal dialogue. One of the channels I watch, one of the streamers said something to the effect of, do you ever do that thing where you're having an internal discussion with yourself and then you just start talking about it out loud as if everyone around could hear what was going on in your head and that they're all just up to speed with the story? I feel like I do that a lot. Like, I'm assuming that you all have the same information that's going on in my head, even if I have not spoken that information aloud. See, right there, I think that pull would be a little bit better with some more side leg to it. But it's really manageable there. So that little pull of that side is going to be one, which is number nine. And then we're going to hit number 10 here. Ooh, that... I don't know if anybody saw how much that bumper flexed when I stuck it on there. But number 10 will be this pull right here. I'm going to get up over here. It's another one where we kind of got to side lug it. That's a good amount of drive right there. We're going to get a little belly stuck. Got to kind of jostle it back and forth to try to pull here. You can get really notched in here. and the objective is to pull. I want to stay here, right here. Can we get the bite? Can we get the bite? One tire is trying to do a lot of work here. Very good. Very good. I have no complaints about that. I just remembered what the other one was. Damn it. So this is the fifth setup. So let's move on to the sixth setup. So it's 12 things. I guess we test 12 things. I've been waiting for that. I've been waiting for that to stop for a good solid minute. But then I remembered that's an ambulance, and here in California, ambulances aren't allowed to do things like run red lights. So he's just now getting past us now. Also, unnecessary disclosures, but you know, I'm an oversharer apparently when it comes to the internet. I was just betrayed by my bucket chair, and it shot out from under me as I sat down, and I fell right on my hip, and I'm an old man. So falling on your hip is something you generally try to avoid. But my watch didn't ask me if I had fallen down. So it must have been a non-event. So I think I'll live. All right. The sand has, I think, firmed up a little bit. Oh yeah, there we go. That's the stuff we're looking for. Get into that sand grinder. Because what we're trying to do is load them up. Okay, got the rears pretty chunked in. But yeah, the fronts didn't pick up nearly as much as I thought they would. So we'll bring it over here. And in number 12, we're gonna try to pick up as much into the tires as possible. How do these do? Yeah. Fairly typical Duratrax behavior, where so long as there's a lug edge clear of the sticky material, you get plenty of bite. The fronts, what little stuck in the fronts cleared out almost immediately. The rears cleared out pretty well too. Now that was pretty sandy. We're gonna get into something right up here. That's a little more muddy. We'll see if that sticks into the tires anymore. But I mean, transitional performance, I would give it a very good, I guess. Brings us to the closure, the closing, the final, the finale. Up the dirt hill. And you see there's a big transition there. So the goal is to use as low of low speed as possible. Try to get a front tire to hook. We're gonna get a lot of side glide usually, because there's not a lot of grip up there, and this will really load the back tires up badly. It's really twisted over here. I'm trying to get that passenger front up that little lip right there. Oh no, I was not going to attempt the self the self right on that one. That mud makes that like sound when your shoes hit it. It is sticky. So the rear tires now are as bad as they're gonna get. Let's see if we can clear the fronts out. Okay, come on, quick, come on. Onto that point, need to be the other side of the point. Now, 1904s made it up. Come on, you got this. Come on, approaches. So good. Now, mental data point comparison. If I was going to give a letter grade overall to this tire, I would give it a strong A-. I think they do phenomenally on this foam. If you were to take a stock Enduro SE, get some beadlocks, throw these on there, they're very good. Almost remarkably good. Their performance transitionally is very good. They have a lot of forward drive. That minus is a notable lack of side lug bite. And I'm a side lug guy. I think they look pretty good. I think they did pretty well. I think the fact that sometimes I have seen them on sale or on discount on like eBay for $17.99 a pair. And at that point, they're really tough to beat because unlike tires like the MT1904 from G-Made, these tires are available. You can shoot over to the retail establishment of your choice and buy these because, I hadn't seen it yet. Oh, there's the tire that landed downside. Oh, we must appreciate this. That is the stuff. Let's get back a little more. I'm impressed. I really am. I'll say it. Despite how well they did, and despite the fact that I think the overall forward drive on the Approach is a little better than the Deepwoods, for me, even on this terrain where the Approach really did shine, this is where you can't escape bias, you know? I give the edge to the Deepwoods because the Deepwoods has more of a side lug bite to it. But in terms of forward drive, I give it to the Approach. I think they might have the most forward drive of any Duratrax offering in Class 2, including the Showdown. I would certainly put these ahead of the Showdown. I would go Deepwoods, Approach, Showdown Scaler. That's my layout. And the Approach is so close to the Deepwoods. It's almost impossibly close. To the point where if you're not as much of an acolyte to the church of side lug, you would probably actually like these more. So there you go. There you have it. There's your wrap. The Duratrax Approach CR. I'd say double thumbs up. I would say recommended. Certainly at that price point. It's very competitive. And like it's going up against my Dead Ringer Canyon Trails, which, yes, I will admit, take a lot of work. In terms of simplicity, you take these out of the package, don't buy pre-mounts, you take these out of the package, you mount them up, and you've got a damn good tire. I'm at least adjacent to blown away. Very, very good Duratrax Approach, very good baseline. Let's go get you cleaned up, you muddy little man. Let's thank all the people for watching. Let's invite them to come back to see whatever comes next. Let's definitely invite them one and all to comment below. Subscribe if they haven't. Please do consider a channel membership. Help support the channel so that we can do more tire tests. Because we love tire tests. Who doesn't love a tire test? And we ask that in between now and when we meet again, which will hopefully be soon, but nevertheless, in that amount of time, please one and all, do your very best. Have a good one, everybody. We will catch you next time.